गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज बेनिफिट कॉस्ट रेशियो एनालिसिस। एक्चुअली दिस एनालिसिस इज वेरी पॉपुलर फॉर इवोल्यूशन ऑफ अ प्रोजेक्ट एंड इट इज़ द रेशियो ऑफ प्रेजेंट वर्थ मेथड फॉर कैश इनफ्लोज ओवर द प्रेजेंट वर्थ ऑफ कैश आउटफ्लोज। ओके, बेनिफिट कॉस्ट रेशियो इज अ रिलेटिव मेजर फॉर द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ अ प्रोजेक्ट and for that it is also the improvement over net worth present analysis of method for project evaluation. And it is a relative measure and it is presented in a quotient or ratio form. Here a formula is given to you, a benefit cost ratio, which is B divided by C, B for present worth of benefit and divided by present worth of cost. Yes, so here present worth of benefit is written as a numerator and present worth of cost that is written in as a denominator. Here some assumptions are given to us. If BCR is less than equal to 1, means investment option generates loss. Means if BCR value is less than 1, then it means it generates loss. If BCR is equal to 1, means neither we are getting profit nor loss. If BCR greater than 1, then investment option is profitable. Means if we are getting the BCR ratio that is greater than 1, means we are getting a profit from our organization. Here these terms are elaborated more, so no need to explain again. Now we will see example number 1. So example 1 is, a firm is trying to decide which of the two devices to install to reduce cost. Both devices have a useful lives of 5 years and no salvage value. Device A cost rupees 1000 and can be expected to result in rupees 300 saving annually. Device B cost is 1350 and will provide cost of rupees 300 first year, but the saving will increase by 50 annually, making the second year saving that is 350, third year 400 and so forth. With interest at 7%, which device should firm purchase? Actually, this example, question is already we have done in a previous lecture, before 3 or 4 lectures. So here the basic calculation is done same, but after getting the present worth calculation, we have to find out the benefit cost ratio. Okay, so first here a present worth of cost that is rupees 1000 rupees. Yes, so here we are device A and device B. A cost of device A that is rupees 1000 rupees and annually we are getting 1300 rupees as a saving. For B, its cost is 1350 rupees and annually gradually this savings is increased by rupees 50. First year we are getting 300, second year we are getting 350, third year we are getting 400 and fourth year we are getting 450 and so on. Here interest rate is the same for both machines, so here interest rate is 7%. Yes, so first we have to find out the present worth benefit. Yes, so here the formula for present worth benefit, P is equal to A in bracket A plus I raised to N minus 1 divided by I in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. Yes, so here putting all the values, A means that is annual income. Yes, so here for machine A our annual income is 300 rupees. Yes, so after doing all calculation we are getting 1230.05. now we have to find out the benefit cost ratio. The formula of benefit cost ratio, that is present worth of benefit divided by present worth of cost. So here present worth of benefit that we are getting, that is 1230 rupees, and here present worth of cost, that is rupees 1000. Yes, so here a cost ratio, that is 1.23. Now if we are doing calculation for device B, so here present worth cost, that is 1350 rupees, and present worth of benefit, so here our saving is increased annually. Yes, so our saving is increased 50 rupees annually. So here whenever the saving is not same, so at that time we have to use this formula. So A in bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 divided by I in bracket 1 plus I raised to n bracket complete plus G in bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus I n minus 1. I n means I for interest, n for number of years. Yes, divided by I raised to 2 in bracket 1 plus I raised to n. Yes, so this kind of calculation we have already done in a 3 or 4 lectures before. Yes, so same calculation is done in this way here. So here after doing all calculations, we are getting 1612.38 rupees as a present worth of benefit. Yes, now we are applying the formula of benefit cost ratio. Yes, so here present worth of benefit is what? So that is 1612 rupees 0.38 divided by present worth of cost, that is 1350 rupees. Yes, so here we are getting 1.19. So here BC ratio for device A, that is 1.23, and BC ratio for device B, that is 1.19. Yes, so here benefit cost ratio, which ratio is more, that device is preferable to choose. Yes, so here device A is preferred because its value is more than device B. So here device A is preferable. Okay, our next point is sensitivity and break-even analysis. Yes, so sensitivity and break-even analysis, that is used for measuring the testing of robustness of the results when uncertainty in input is present. So here in most business activities, whenever the business activities are performed under dynamic business environment, and we don't know, we can't predict that business environment. Yes, so at that time whenever we have to take a decision for our business under a risky environment, uncertain environment, so at that time sensitivity analysis method is chosen. Yes, so it is a mathematical model. Yes, it measures the proportionate change in independent variable and its impact on dependent variable under the given set of assumptions. Yes, so here one example is given to us. Estimated annual maintenance and salvage values may vary substantially. Sensitivity analysis may indicate that a certain decision is insensitive to salvage value estimation over full range of possible values, but at the same time it is found that the decision is sensitive to change in an annual maintenance estimation. So under these circumstances, great emphasis is kept on improving the annual maintenance estimation and less on salvage value estimation. Yes, so here whenever we have to take sensitivity analysis, after some years, whenever we are selling our products or our equipments, so at that time we are getting some salvage value based on its condition and based on its current demand. Yes, so sensitivity analysis is taken whenever if any maintenance is required for our organization. Yes, So for that we have to take a decision, and based on that we are taking sensitivity analysis. Okay, so here one example is given to us. What is the sensitivity of a decision to second stick construction 16 or more years in a future? All facilities will last for 40 years regardless of when they are installed. After 40 years, they will have zero salvage value. Annual cost of operation and maintenance is the same for both two-stage construction and full capacity construction. Interest rate is 8% for both cases. Now, what we have to do? So here in a first line shows we have to apply sensitivity analysis formula. Yes, so here what is the sensitivity of decisions? Okay, so here we have to pick up a keyword, that is sensitivity. Yes, so to second stage construction 16 or more years in a future. Yeah, so based on first lines we have to find out after how many years we have to find out the sensitivity decisions for these all facilities. Yes, now come to the second line. Second line is all facilities will last for 40 years regardless of when they are installed. Okay, so for last 40 years these facilities will last for 40 years when they are installed, means whatever the facilities are installed that will end up to 40 years. After 40 years they will zero salvage value, means whenever this equipment is sold after 40 years, so we are not getting anything. Yes, so that's why that is zero salvage value. Annual cost of operation and maintenance is the same for both two-stage construction and full capacity construction. So here we have to do calculations in both way, two-way construction and full capacity construction. Yes, and here interest rate is 8% for both cases. Yes, so here one table is given to us, that is construction alternative. Cost is also given to us. Here first one is two stage construction and full capacity construction. Yes, two stage construction is bifurcated into two ways. First is construct first stage and construct second stage. Yes, so construct first stage value is 1 lakh and construct second stage its value is 1,20,000 rupees. Now full capacity, full capacity construction its value is 1,40,000. Now come to the next slide. So first we have to do calculation for two stage constructions. We have a formula, present worth of cost, that is P plus F in bracket 1 in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. Yes, so here present worth value, that is 1 lakh rupees. F means what? So 1,20,000 rupees. So here see second stage value, that is 1,20,000. Yes, and after calculating these, so when n is equal to 5, means number of years is equal to 5, then present worth cost value we are getting, that is 1,81,700 rupees. In the same way we have to do a calculation up to 30, actually we have to do calculation up to 40 years. Here up to 30 years the calculation is given to us. So in this way we have to calculate two stage construction. Yes, just we have to apply one formula, present worth of cost formula. Yes, so here that is given to us. So for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 25 years and 30 years we have to apply this formula. Now come to the next part, that is full capacity construction. Yes, so full capacity construction its cost is 1,40,000 rupees. So here for full capacity construction, so here present worth of cost 1, which is equal to present worth of cost 2. Here in an example that is given to us, सी सेकंड लास्ट लाइन, एनुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड मेंटेनेंस इज सेम फॉर बोथ टू स्टेज कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड फुल कैपेसिटी कंस्ट्रक्शन. यस, सो हियर, सो प्रेजेंट वर्थ ऑफ कॉस्ट वन विच इज इक्वल टू प्रेजेंट वर्थ ऑफ कॉस्ट टू. यस, सो प्रेजेंट वर्थ ऑफ कॉस्ट दैट इज 140,000 फॉर फुल्ली कैपेसिटी कंस्ट्रक्शन. यस, सो वी हैव टू राइट डाउन हियर एंड पी प्लस एंड द सेम फॉर्मूला इज अप्लाइड टू हियर. सो हियर बोथ टेक्निक्स आर इक्विवेलेंट टू ईच अदर, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी आर कंपेयरिंग विद ईच अदर. सो 140,000 विच इज इक्वल टू 1 lakh प्लस 120,000 इन ब्रैकेट 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस 0.08 रेस टू एन. यस, वी हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट एन ईयर्स. यस, सो 1 प्लस 0.08 रेस टू एन डिवाइडेड बाय 1 सॉरी विच इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय 0.33%. सो आफ्टर डूइंग दैट, आफ्टर डूइंग अ कैलकुलेशन, वी आर गेटिंग एन इज इक्वल टू 14.3 years. यस, सो आफ्टर 14.3 years वी हैव टू टेक अ डिसीजन फॉर यूजिंग सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस. यस, नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इकोनॉमिक एनालिसिस इन पब्लिक सेक्टर. यस, सो हियर फॉर पब्लिक सेक्टर हाउ कैन वी यूज इकोनॉमिक एनालिसिस. So here there is a difference between evaluation of capital projects of private sector and public sector. So here in a private sector which strives to maximize profit comparing to the public sector because which strives to maximize social welfare. Yes, so here one problem is generated, that is evaluation. So evaluation of public sector is uneconomic nature of measuring the benefit and the cost. Why? Because the cost and benefits are not qualifying in reliable way like public sector projects and their measurement in monetary terms. Yes, so here standard appraisal method for evaluating the private sector capital projects like rate of return on investment, net present value, internal rate of return, and it cannot be applied to the public sector projects where the cost and benefits are not directly measurable. Yes, so here in a public sector enterprises, so here cost benefit analysis approach we have to apply. So here selecting the interest rate. Yes, so selecting the interest rate, so for that first, how can we select the interest rate in a private sector as well as in a government sector? Yes, so no time value of money. Yes, means in a government, money is obtained from the taxation and spent quickly as they are obtained. Means whenever we are getting the money from taxation, then this money is spent to the another work. So here there is one delay, there is a time delay between collecting money from taxpayer and spending it to the another expenditure. Second point is cost of capital. Yes, so here most government borrow money for capital expenditure in addition to collecting tax. So here this money is borrowed in a specific project and it is used for interest rate equal to the cost of borrowed money. Yes, means government is borrowed money from the another private sector and those money are paid with the help of taxation. Yes, next one is opportunity cost. So here this cost is different to all government agencies and subdivisions. Yes, so based on opportunity, they are getting a different opportunity cost. We have already discussed this opportunity cost topic, cost of capital topic, time value of money topic in a previous lectures. We have already seen benefit cost ratio. Okay, so benefit cost ratio, that is very simple, but here we have to take care about the which kind of assumptions are needed in a public investment. Yes, and how money is occupied to different resources, because public money is committed for every year through such analysis. The same way a project financing, so based on investment in equipments, facilities and other projects, government is given a finance, while in a private firm that rely on money from investors, private lenders and retaining earning from operations. Yes, so how can we finance in a government sector, and what is the situation in a public sector? So how public sector is getting money and how government sector is getting money. Next one is project duration. So here project duration is based on a project. If project is very big, then it takes 5 to 10 years. So based on project, for example, we have already taken the example, if project is for a dam, road construction, so this kind of large projects, these kind of large projects, okay, so this kind of large projects take more time. Yes, if there is small project, then it takes less time, and we are getting money back which is borrowed from the other private or public sector. Yes, so that is depends on project, if whether the project is large or that project is small. Okay, so here our chapter is completed. Thank you, students.